The decline has been abrupt. Tourists have practically vanished from the historic town of Antakya. Businesses and shopkeepers are some of the hardest hit. In recent months, the presence of Al-Qaeda groups and foreign fighters on the Turkish-Syrian border, store owners say, has made everyone more afraid and tense. And no one wants to show his face on camera. But a few kilometers away, though fewer, trucks line up for days and wait for the border to open. Transportation has been Hatay's money-making machine and the province Turkey's gate to the Middle East. Now the time to transfer the goods has tripled and the cost has risen.
Yani şey bu olay başladığında, bu kapı kapanmaya başladığında mecburen hani ikinci bir alternatif olarak limanı seçmek zorunda kaldım. Ya şu anda Antakya ekonomisine hiçbir katkısı yok şu an itibariyle. Çünkü zaten şimdi nakliye yönünü önce düşünürsek, yani nakliye olarak değerlendirirsek bu Suriye'deki olan olayların çıkmasından dolayı çoğu nakliye firması zaten iflas etti.
For other Turks, the border has become a lucrative business. Long waits force people to pay over 1.5 euro for parking at the border post. Smuggling on both sides is booming. But in many ways, the influx of Syrians has boosted local economy and everyone tries to profit. Syrian restaurants, cafes and markets spring up alongside the Turkish ones. They provide much needed jobs to Syrians, but opportunity often comes with competition.
أنا بهذا المحل أول شغلة السوريين أخذوا كثير محلات في تركيا بريحانية فصار في كثير من المقاهي صار في كثير مطاعم هذا الموضوع بيأثر على الشغل هون بالقهوة بعدين وقت أنا عم بدفع 3000 دولار بالشهر يعني أنا ما عم بربح أنا ضليت هلا أنا صلي كم شهر أنا عم بخسر
Abdul Khalid will soon shut down his cafe in Reyhanli, a town where it is said there are as many Syrians as Turks. But with no end in sight to the Syrian war, someone else may soon try to profit. Filio Contrafuri, CCTV, Hatay.